Yesterday, I put up a poll. I've been in the mood. I've been having a craving, a need to play a Fallout game, and I left it up to you guys. I put up a poll yesterday. Would you guys like to see Fallout 3, Fallout New Vegas, or Fallout 4? An overwhelming majority said Fallout New Vegas. So here we are. We are about to start a brand new series. This is going to get thrown into the rotation of videos here on this channel. I have not played New Vegas since, like, probably high school, 2012. This game came out in 2010, and I remember very little, so it's going to be almost like playing it for the first time. Also, I'm playing it on PC, which, when I bought it, I bought the complete bundle, which came with like 6 or 7 DLC packs for $20. Yes, $20. So, that being said, let's start a new game. I'm so excited. This is basically like playing the game for the very first time. Viva Las Vegas 2025. Oh my god. That's not that far away. These cutscenes are probably going to be a little bit, this is the only cutscene, but I went ahead and audio balanced everything. Oh, this is so cool. Gosh, this is really cool. The Vegas Strip at night. This actually looks really nice. It looks like a really nice safe haven. And then of course, things get a little bit dicey outside the walls. See what I did? I quite literally did not even mean to make that pun, but oof. That's tough. That is tough, and I believe this cutscene should show what happens to us in the beginning here. Yep. If I remember correctly, we were a courier, and we had a special package.
War never changes.
Wait, what?
When atomic fire consumed the Earth,
war never changes. Is that like a tagline?
Great underground vaults.
I guess. I guess it's like a tagline.
Their inhabitants set out across the ruins of the old world to build new societies, establishing
great cons. Obviously, war never changes is like the big tagline from like the beginning of Fallout 4.
What had been the American Southwest united beneath
new California Republic, the two-headed bear. That's so
dedicated
cool.
To old world values of democracy and the rule of law. As the Republic grew, so did its needs. Scouts spread east,
Republic,
seeking territory and wealth in the dry and merciless expanse of the Mojave Desert.
The Mojave Desert, that's right.
They returned with tales of a city untouched by the warheads that had scorched the rest of the world.
Yeah, that's crazy.
The Great Wall spanning the Colorado River.
The Hoover Dam, the Great
Wall.
The
NCR mobilized its army and sent it east to occupy Hoover Dam,
yep,
and restore it to working condition.
God, can you imagine?
But across the Colorado, another society had arisen under a different flag. A vast army of slaves forged from the conquest of 86 tribes, Caesar's Legion.
Caesar's Legion. I remember
4 years
that.
Have passed since the Republic held the dam.
There's like four or five different factions.
The Legion did not retreat. Across the river, it gathers strength. Campfires burn, training drums beat.
I remember like
through
the final
all,
siege
the New Vegas Strip has stayed open for business under the control of its mysterious overseer, Mr. House, and his army of rehabilitation.
Mr. House, I do remember.
Police robots.
Little police robots, that's funny.
You are a courier hired by the Mojave Express to deliver a package to the,
yep,
New Vegas Strip.
And we never made
what
it.
What seemed like a simple delivery job has taken a turn for the worse.
Which is so weird because, like, I feel like if you made it out of this.
You got what you were after, so pay up.
Uh oh.
You're crying in the rain, Pally.
Gang
guess is waking up over here.
Yikes.
Time to cash out.
Can you imagine?
Will you get it over with?
Maybe cons kill people without looking them in the face. But I ain't a fink. Dig? You've made your last delivery, kid. Sorry you got twisted up in this scene.
Tough.
From where you're kneeling must seem like an 18-carat run of bad luck. Truth is, the game was rigged from the start.
Tough. Bethesda Software presents an Obsidian Entertainment production. I'm going to turn this down just a little bit. This is really loud. I turn off the music in the actual game. And, that'll be just fine. I think the music should be turned off still. All right, mercenary pack items added to inventory. We also got the caravan pack items. And there's a couple more things too, I think. Tribal pack items. Yeah, we got a lot of good stuff here.
How about that?
Classic pack items. Cool, cool, cool.
Whoa, easy there.
Hey, whoa. Easy
there.
You've
been out cold a couple of days now. Why don't you just relax a second? Get your bearings.
Yeah.
Let's see what the damage is. How about your name?
Oh,
can you tell me your name?
What's our name? Our name. Well, I think I have to actually type it in. Is CNP. Our name is CNP.
I can't say it's what I'd have picked for you, but if that's your name, that's your name.
Yeah, you know. I'm really bad at picking names for myself anyway, so.
Now, I hope you don't mind, but I had to go rooting around there in your noggin to pull all the bits of lead out.
Yikes.
I take pride in my needlework, but you'd better tell me if I left anything out of place.
Okay. What is that supposed to mean? Let's see here.
How'd I do?
Let's go male and Caucasian, and I'm just gonna like hit random a bunch of times. And whatever we come out with. Okay. Why does our character look like Shooter McGavin? I don't know, but I'm cool with this. Wait, let's give him some age. Now he definitely looks like Shooter McGavin. What the heck? Alright. We'll go with like middle-aged kind of deal. And hairstyle, smooth wave. Sure, hair color, sure, facial hair, goatee, rough beard, survivalist, beatnik, gunslinger, the gentleman, mutton stash, shaggy sideburns, soul patch, old coot, the Gettysburg, chopper, chin strip, honest Abe, man's man, swashbuckler, ladies man, tough guy, Machiavellian, chin dusting, cavalry, daddy O, backwater, roughneck, thin strip, shag strip, touch of soul, tire track, the comrade, chin scruff, Manchurian, doom rider, Mephistopheles, Bristly Ghoul, El Carcinero, Hombre, Renegade, Gruff Stuff. There is so many. What the heck? Are you kidding me? Ronin. I actually kind of like that. Let's go with Ronin. We were in the last two. Let's go with Ronin. I'm cool with that. Yes, this is going to be our character.
Most of it right anyway. Stuff that mattered. Okay. No
fair. Fair. Now, what I do remember about this game is there's a little bit difference in the character creation. There's like perks and stuff that you get to pick from the very beginning.
The end of the room? Over by that bigger tester machine there. Take it
bigger
slow
tester.
It
nice. Let's see.
Look
they're just fine. And let's activate it now. We have the typical, like, special strength perception. What is it? Strength perception, endurance, charisma, intelligence, agility, and luck. So, the typical system. We have 4 points to add. Let's take a look at everything here. Strength effects, your melee, unarmed, inventory weight, damage, weapon, damage, and weapon effectiveness. Perceptions, explosives, lockpick, energy weapons, accuracy, compass range. Endurance is unarmed, health, resistance, and survival. Charisma, barter, speech, companion, and nerve, or companion nerve. Intelligence, science, repair, medicine, and skill points. I want to go with like a highly intelligent. I think I want to go with like a highly intelligent player for sure. Agility, guns, sneak, speed, action point regeneration. I do like adding a little bit there. All skills, critical hits, and enemy mishaps. I think I'm going to maybe take some off of like, maybe take some off of, maybe perception or even strength. I think I'm going to take one off of strength. Strength was already at 6, so that brings it back down to 5. I think I may have accidentally put something on strength. And we're going to put one on luck. Just to get a little bit more on all of our skills, I think. And then, yeah, this looks good. So 5, 5, 5, 5, 8, 6, and 8. We could actually, like, take down maybe, like, perception. You know what? Oh. I didn't mean to do that. I think I have a second chance to fix it, but...
Well, we know your vitals are good.
Okay.
But that don't mean them bullets didn't leave you nutted.
Right off the bat, I think I want to do settings display and change my HUD color to like a blue, maybe. Same with this. And yeah. There we go. That's
what do you say? You take a seat.
That's way more visually appealing for sure. I hated that like yellowy look, that yellow glow. It was ugly. Alright, sit down on the couch. This game does look better than I remember, or like, it doesn't look bad,
all
but
right.
It also doesn't look the best.
I'm gonna say a word. I want you to say the first thing that comes to mind.
Deal.
Dog.
Train. Newspaper.
House.
Cat. House. Shelter. Burglarize. Renovate. Target. Investment. Demolish. I'm gonna say investment.
Night.
Campfire. Dream. Shroud. Sleep. Treasure. Silencer. Dream. Do I do dream or sleep? I'm gonna do dream.
Bandit.
Bribe. Crush. Stab. Swiss cheese. Vaporize. Reasonable. I'm gonna say Swiss cheese.
Light.
Light. Dark. Heavy. Beam. Flash. Inspiration. Torch. I'm gonna say flash, maybe.
Mother.
Caretaker. Jeans. Cookie jar. Tantrum. Tattle. Regret. Human shield. I'll say caretaker.
Okay. Now I got a few statements.
I want you to tell me how much they sound like something you'd say.
First one. Conflict just ain't in my nature.
Let's say no opinion.
I ain't given to relying on others for support.
I would agree with that.
I'm always fixing to be the center of attention.
I'd say disagree on that.
I'm slow to embrace new ideas.
Oh. Strongly disagree. I wanna be able to...
I charge in to deal with my problems head on.
I would agree with that.
Almost done here. What do you say you have a look at this?
What is this?
Tell me what you see.
A broken chain, a chemical reaction, a shadow in a door frame, an oozing wound, an angry two-headed ant. Actually, it looks kind of like a two-headed ant to me. I'll say a chemical, it almost looks like DNA.
Okay. How about this one?
That looks like two guns together. I see a priceless work of art, some piece of space-age technology, a ship at sea. I'm too embarrassed.
Last one.
A light in the darkness, a bearded man, a mushroom cloud, a head on a pillow. I'll say a light in the darkness.
Well, I don't have nothing to compare it to, so maybe you'd better just have a look at the results.
See if it all seems right to you. Okay. Let's see here. Medicine, melee weapons, and science. I don't like using melee weapons, so let's take that off. Let's do maybe guns or repair, sneak, speech, survival. Let's do maybe guns. Guns determine your effectiveness with any weapon that uses conventional ammunition. Or I could do like energy weapons or explosives. Or barter. I like the idea of doing like barter. Prices you get for buying and selling in general, the higher the barter. It's always good to have a good barter skill. And then we got science. It can also be used to recycle energy weapons and ammunition at workbenches. Primarily used to hack restricted. You know, that's always good. Being able to hack is good. And then we'll rock with that.
Before I turn you loose, I need that. One more thing from you. You got a form for you to fill out.
I think this is where I like get to pick.
Just a formality.
Like a couple more perks kind of deal. History of getting shot in the head. Let's see what we got. Built to destroy. It's a trait, so the flamer that burns twice as bright burns half as long. All weapons have 3% chance to critically hit, but equipment conditions decay. No, heck no. Claustrophobia. You have a fear of enclosed spaces. You gain +1 to special attributes when outside, but suffer -1 when indoors. I don't hate that, but I feel like most of the time you are indoors. Early bird, hey, early risers enjoy +2 to each of your special attributes from 6 a.m. to 12 p.m., but suffer a -1 from 6 p.m. Now, fast shot. While using guns and energy weapons, you fire 20% more quickly, but your shots are 20% less accurate. While wearing any types of glasses, you have +1. Without glasses, you have -1. And we could just always have glasses on. That would be good. Good-natured. You're good-natured at heart, more prone to solving problems with your mind than violence. You gain +5 to barter, medicine, repair, science, and speech, but have -5 to energy weapons, explosives, guns, melee weapons, and unarmed. I don't hate that. I like being able to have like higher like passive traits in the beginning, because you can quickly level up your gun traits. It's harder to level up your passive traits. Your melee and unarmed attack do more damage but less critical. Hoarder, gain 25. Making myself tired here. 25 pounds to your carrying capacity but suffer a -1 to all action. No, heck no. Hot-blooded, my health drops below 50%, you gain 10% more damage, but you also suffer -2 to your agility and perception. No. Kamikaze, you have +10 action points, but your reckless nature causes you to have -2 damage threshold. No. Logan's loophole, does it change? How the heck, is it really Logan? Is this the name of the perk, or because I didn't say my name is Logan. You stay level 30 forever. You'll never again become addicted to chems. But level 30, after level 30, you can kiss experience perks and skill points. Goodbye. No. Loose cannon. 25% less range. Skilled. You gain +5 points to every skill, but you suffer -10 experience from experience gained from now on. Small frame. Limbs are easily more crippled. while using guns and energy weapons, you fire 20% more slowly, but are 20% more accurate. I think I like that. I think I'd like the idea of being more accurate in a wild wasteland. Unleashes the most bizarre and silly elements of post-apocalyptic America, not for the faint of heart or serious temperament. Is this like playing on hard mode or something? I like the idea of doing trigger discipline and then small frame. Limbs are more easily crippled, but that's fine. We can always fix that because we're pretty solid. We're a good medic. I don't like the idea of getting plus 5 to every skill, but 10% our experience. Yeah. Let's do either that, or we could do 4 eyes and just always have, yeah, you know what? Let's do 4 eyes instead. And we'll just make sure we're always wearing glasses. Perfect.
All right. I guess that about does it. Come with me. I'll see you out.
Thanks, Doc. Appreciate you. My guy. And I think there's actually, like, probably some stuff here that we can maybe take and wear. Baseball glove. Gun case. Wow. Wait, what? Nice. Don't mind me. I'm just gonna take that. Stim pack. Don't come over here, Doc. I'm just stealing all your stuff here. Oh, there we go. Look at that. Come here. And actually, how do I sneak? Wait, what? How can I? Okay, reading glasses and then today's physician. That's actually like a mega stim pack, right? If I remember right. Blood pack, yes, please. Medex, yes, please. Surgical tubing. Oh my god, Apollo is literally in the other room and you can hear him snoring. Paperweight, okay. And we are playing on, we're playing on very hard. Or, no, not very hard, but hard. So, I think. Let me just double check real fast. Gameplay. Yeah, we're playing on hard, so it will be a little difficult. I might have to bump it down, but I've played so many Fallout
here,
games.
These are yours. It was all you had on you when you was brought in. I hope you don't mind, but I gave the note a look. I thought it might help me find a next of kin, but it was just something about a platinum chip.
Platinum chip.
Well, if you're heading back out there, you ought to have this. They call it a Pip-Boy. I grew up in one of them vaults they made before the war. We all got one.
A Pip-Boy.
Ain't much use to me now, but you might want such a thing after what you've been through.
What a nice guy.
I know what it's like having something taken from you.
What a nice guy.
And put this on, too, so the locals don't pick on you for lacking modesty. Never was much.
Thanks for patching me up, Doc. You shouldn't have gone through my stuff. What do I do now?
Don't mention it.
What kind of jerk would say you shouldn't have gone through my stuff?
You should talk to Sunny Smiles before you leave town.
Bro, I was dead.
She can help you learn to fend for yourself in the desert. She'll likely be at the saloon. I reckon some of the other folks at the saloon might be able to help you out, too. And the metal fella, Victor, who pulled you out of your grave.
Victor.
Anyway, you ever get hurt out there, you come right back. Oh, but try not.
Okay. Hardcore mode. No, thank you. Let's see, what do we want to wear here? We can do armored Vault 13 jumpsuit. Wow. We can do lightweight, so it's a little bit less weight. Same amount of armor too. Wait, what? Damage threshold, WG is what weight, right? Lightweight metal armor. Oh, -1 to agility. Pre-war add, +1 to perception. Reading glasses, +2 to perception. Wait a minute. Vault 21 jumpsuit. Doesn't have any damage, but gives you +2 to speech and +2 to melee weapons. I don't really care about melee weapons that much. I'm gonna just wear my armored Vault 13 jumpsuit, I think. But look at us. Can you not flip the camera? that you can flip the camera in this game to, like, see the front of... Oh, video games. How they used to be so funny. So funny. Alright. So that actually... Wait. Apparel can consist of many different types of gear, ranging from clothing, armor, to sunglasses and hats. DT is some apparel grants damage threshold. To the wearer, your DT is the sum of all DT or currently equipped apparel plus any bonuses from perks or chems. DT is directly subtracted from incoming damage, so a higher DT provides superior protection. Perfect. Condition is just condition, affects how much protection it provides. Apparel above 50% condition provides maximum protection. Light, medium, heavy. Medium and heavy apparel will slow characters down when equipped. And then repair. I want to see our ammunition is used by almost all guns and energy. Armor piercing. Hollow point does more damage but is easily blocked by armor. Overcharge increases damage but degrades the weapon more quickly. Slug used by shotguns. Replace buckshot with a single large bullet is more accurate. Cool. I want to see what our stats are now. Yeah, stats. Perception is already a 7 because of all the stuff that we put on. I'm glad we took some points off of there. So this actually determines when red compass markings appear. Lockpick, energy, explosives, intelligence. The more skill points you'll be able to distribute when you level up. That's why we wanted a high intelligence. Really helps out the early game. And oh man. Oh, it's so bright. You've got a fragmented signal on your Pip-Boy, a coded transmission of some sort with a sad, jazzy undercut that makes your head hurt. As far as you can tell, it appears to be an invitation to the Midnight Science Fiction feature at the Mojave Drive-In. Please arrive early to catch the trailers. Old War Blues has been loaded. Your level cap has been raised by 5. Okay, your Pip-Boy has received a signal, coordinates that lead to the canyon wreckage west of Prim. Following the coordinates are the words Courier 6. It's signed Ulysses. Lonesome Road has been loaded. Your level cap has been increased by 5. Pip-Boy has picked up a radio broadcast from the Happy Trails Caravan Company. They're looking for one or more members for an expedition to Zion Valley. Again, level cap increased by 5. Okay, so settings, audio. I want to lower the voice just a little bit. That was a little bit too loud. But please don't be Victor. Okay, here's Victor. Gunrunners has been loaded.
Howdy, partner.
Oh my god.
Might I say you...
Still way too loud there, sir.
You're looking fit as a fiddle.
Thank you. Thanks for taking me out of the grave.
I'm always ready to lend a helping hand to a stranger in need.
Appreciate that. Thank you so much. How'd you happen to find me?
I was out for a stroll that night when I heard the commotion up at the old bone orchard.
Saw a bunch of bad eggs.
So I laid low. Once they'd run off, I dug you up to see if you were still kicking. Turns out you were. So I hauled you off to the dock right quick.
Nice.
Can't say that I'm familiar with the rascals.
I might even turn down the voices just a little bit lower.
Help you out with that.
How did you... Let's see. I've never seen a robot like you before.
I'm a Securitron.
Robco Security Model 2060B.
If you ever see any of my brothers, tell them Victor says howdy.
Alright.
Happy trails.
Alright, I'm gonna...